these fascinating floaters can grow to be wider than a transport truck and are famous for being able to support the weight of an average 10-year-old. But this plant isn't here for child's play. With its spiny underbelly and aspirations for pond domination, this lily is a true conqueror. This is Victoria amazonica.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. The poshest plant in the pond is clearly Victoria amazonica. Nope, that is not the pen name I use to write romance novels. It's the biggest lily pad you've ever laid eyes on.
Victoria amazonica has a lot of tools to keep itself safe. And when you're online, you have to make sure to do the same. This video sponsor is here to help. There are real cybersecurity threats out there, and you'll need more protection than having your favorite plant as your password. Cybersecurity experts over at NordVPN introduced us to NordPass. NordPass is more than a password manager. It's the essential cybersecurity tool that makes everyone's life easier and safer. NordPass generates advanced, complex passwords that you don't need to memorize. All passwords are stored in one place, and all you'll need is one master password to access them. There's even an autofill feature that can be synchronized with up to 6 devices at once, so you can log into your favorite accounts even faster. Protect yourself online and register now to get 50% off a 2-year NordPass premium plan using the AnimalLogic promo code. Plus, you'll get an additional month for free. With 24/7 customer support and a 30-day money-back guarantee, you can have full confidence that NordPass is the best fit for you. Thanks for the sponsor, NordPass. Also known as Amazon water lilies or royal water lilies, Victoria amazonica is the largest of the 58 species of the Nymphaeaceae family, and certainly the most striking. These perennials are native to the calm backwaters of rivers in the Amazon basin in South America.
The enormous circular leaves on this water lily can grow up to 3 meters across. That's as wide as a grizzly bear is tall.
The leaves can reach these dizzying dimensions with the support of a series of rigid veins that radiate outwards from the stem on the underside of the leaf. The thick stem itself can grow to be 8 meters long. Supports across the veins create a fractal-like pattern that gives the leaf even more strength and allows it to reach really impressive sizes. The veins also serve to trap small pockets of air that help the leaf stay afloat. The edges of the leaf turn upward and a notch develops that allows water collected on the leaf to run off.
Despite the serious scaffolding underneath, the leaf itself is only about 1 millimeter thick. It's like a ballerina, dainty on the surface, tough as nails underneath.
Being such a large aquatic plant, you'd think that hungry fish and other creatures from down below would want to rip it apart. But Victoria amazonica has thought of everything.
Their leaves evolve sharp, centimeter-long spines that grow along the underside to discourage anything from turning them into a tasty snack.
The giant proportions of the leaf allow for optimal light absorption for photosynthesis. The amount of energy it's able to create balances out the energy it costs to grow to that size. It's like a giant floating solar panel.
And these leaves grow quickly. They go from small bud to meters wide leaf in just 7 days.
The theory behind the evolution of this rapid growth is that they often live in temporarily flooded habitats and need to grow quickly to fight for limited space and time if they want to survive.
And Victoria amazonica will do anything to outlast, even kill. As their leaves grow, they push aside competing plants and skewer them with their sharp spines.
They expand until the leaves completely blanket the surface of the waters they inhabit, blocking out all light and making it impossible for other plant species to live around or underneath them.
If Victoria amazonica were a 90s pop hit, it would definitely be Len's Steal My Sunshine. And if you don't get that reference, ask your parents.
Although you'd think giant leaves with their own built-in defenses would be the most interesting thing about Victoria amazonica, its flowers are also fascinating.
The flowers of these giant lilies are protogynous, meaning that the female parts mature and become male. It's a form of sequential hermaphroditism.
When Victoria amazonica flowers, the beguiling blooms last for only 2 days. On the first day, the female phase, the white flower opens in the evening and gives off a sweet, pineapple-like scent. The aroma specifically targets pollinating beetles, like those in the Cyclocephala genus.
The beetles go in and start eating the spongy, starchy meal the flower provides. Then the flower closes, essentially kidnapping the insects. But they don't mind too much because they're at an all-you-can-eat buffet.
The next day, the flower turns male and starts releasing pollen.
The flower opens slightly so the beetles can get out, but to do so, they have to squeeze past the stamens and get covered in pollen.
Then, they'll fly to another flower in the female phase and cross-pollinate it. The flower in male phase turns variegated pink and white and loses its scent, letting beetles know not to waste their time coming for a meal.
But it's not just their enchantingly fruity smell that attracts beetles. Victoria Amazonica flowers are also thermogenic, meaning they produce heat.
This heat is not only used to enhance the smell of their flowers, but also to provide a toasty reward to their endothermic pollinators. Their flowers can get so hot that they can be up to 11 degrees Celsius warmer than the surrounding air.
The beetles will crawl inside the flower to soak up its heat, and this energy reward has the beetles coming back for more.
Despite knowing that they flock to these flowers, we don't actually know what exactly the beetles do when they hang out inside.
Is this just a beetle's version of a spa day? The science is still out.
Victoria Amazonica has certainly made quite the impression on beetles and people alike, and is highly prized as the jewel of greenhouses throughout the world. Their size and beauty draw crowds wherever they go.
But unless you have a lot of space to keep a large pool of water at 25 degrees Celsius year-round, you probably won't be able to grow one of these gorgeous giants at home. You'll just have to travel to a greenhouse to see one for yourself. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. See ya. The enormous water lilies, the ginormous circular leaves on this water lily can grow up to 3 meters across. That's as wide as a grizzly bear is tall. Since, of course, you're looking at grizzly bears all the time. Please maintain a social distance of 2/3 of a grizzly bear.
And if you ain't heard, grizzly bears is tall!
Grizzly bears is tall.